I've seen you try durian, Rio. Impressive.
Yeah, I've tried that. That was nice. The carrot cake was really nice. That was my favourite when we done the eating challenge together. Sergio looked like he hadn't had breakfast. He was eating quick, he ate a lot of food. But yeah, the food was nice. I like trying different food, and that's always when I come to Asia. I love Asian food and the different variety and stuff. So today, to taste the food was my favourite part of the show.
Great. So have you spent much time in Asia? Just mainly on football tours?
Yeah, mainly on football tours. But I mean, like last year I was here in Singapore for a couple of days, Indonesia, Thailand, so Malaysia. I've been quite a few places.
Good stuff. Right, same question to Sergio. What have been your favourite moments? Rio said you've been eating like a horse. Is that the favourite bit?
No, my favourite is durian.
Durian?
Durian.
Durian, there we go. It divides opinion, durian. Come on, give him a round of applause. Durian lovers.
Durian y... Después la gente, la verdad que muy bien. Gracias a Sintel, a Samsung por traerme acá y la verdad que la estoy pasando muy bien.
Great stuff. Thank you, Sergio. Okay, second question is to Mr. Rio Ferdinand. It's from Asil, Asilo98. What and who inspired you to be a footballer, Rio?
That's an easy question to answer. When I was a kid, 1986, I was laying on my sofa watching the TV and the World Cup was on, and Diego Maradona scored not the handball, but he scored the goal against England when he ran through the whole team, and it was the best goal I've ever seen.
So why did you then become a centre back, Rio?
I got converted when I got to about 13 or 14, but yeah, that was my moment where I thought, wow, I'd love to be a footballer, inspired by him. I was fortunate enough to meet him, but he's been my inspiration as a young kid growing up to be a footballer.
What better inspiration can you get than Mr. Maradona? Right, question to Sergio, this is from Sean. What's your first impression of Singapore from the moment you've set foot here? And what do you plan to do in your free time?
Primero la impresión en la ciudad, la verdad que impresionante y bueno, es la primera vez que vengo, me quedé muy contento con eso. Quisiera quedarme más días, pero no puedo.
Who would really like to stay here longer?
The next question? Tiempo libre.
¿Qué hago?
Ojalá pudiera hacer muchas cosas, pero ahora estoy trabajando, así que... Pero me gustaría poder relajarme, que es una ciudad muy para quedarse tranquilo y después de un año de jugar.
Okay, a question to Rio then. I mean, it's been a long season for you guys, but how does it feel watching, you know, Sergio and the rest of the noisy neighbors win the championship?
I wondered how long it would take for someone to ask such a question. Yes, it's never enjoyable to watch another team win something that you consider your own. We always have a big rivalry with Manchester City, but in the last 3 years, they've been challenging more. So the rivalry goes up and up and up. So it was always more Liverpool, but now I'd say it's very similar between us and them in terms of rivalries. So, but as I said, you have to be respectful. We've had a very good time in the last 15 years, 20 years. With the winning the league and stuff, so whenever anyone else wins it, we know how hard it is to win. So we have to say respect to them guys for winning it this year. They're not happy, but you have to say well done.
You can console yourself with 6 Premier League title medals, though, Rio. It's not bad.
Doesn't mean anything now.
Hi, Rio. Sorry to bring up the events of what just happened, but after having a few days to reflect on the news about your contract and everything, can you tell us about your future and how you feel, what you're thinking, how much of a shock it was, maybe?
Future-wise, I'm not sure. This commitment was fortunately given to me, and thank you to Samsung and Singtel. So coming out here has really been like a blessing in disguise as well. I've been able to get away from the hype and stuff, and really enjoying my time here, and I haven't had much time really to think about my next step. In the coming days, I'm sure I'll end up start to do that and to kind of have a decision on what was going to happen. But now, as I said, I've thrown myself into this, I'm enjoying it, and it's taken my mind off that.
Question for Sergio. How do you feel about Carlos Tevez not being in the World Cup squad? How do you feel about
it? I already asked him.
Es una decisión del técnico, así que en eso no puedo meter. Así que.
Okay,
I've got a different answer. Oh, sorry.
We'd take him in the England squad, wouldn't we, Rio? Would we have Tevez in our England squad?
He's not English.
No, if we could. Hypothetical.
I think he's a great player.
Hi, this is for Aguero. We've had an injury-filled season at the BPL. How do you think it's going to fare at the World Cup?
No, bien. La verdad que tuve un par de lesiones y la última semana un poco mejor. Así que espero poder hacer un buen mundial porque tenemos un gran equipo y esperemos que nos salga todo bien.
Rio, what do you think about the passion for football here in Singapore, particularly Premier League football?
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy. I think the fans here are very passionate. They love the Premier League. They love Manchester United. The minute we stepped off the plane, crazy, loads of people in the airport, and my wife was like, whoa, does this normally happen? We don't normally go away and this kind of happens. I said, you're in Asia. This is what happens in Asia. So it's a great place to come. We enjoy it. I love it. And like Sergio said, the culture is fantastic. And if you can embrace that and enjoy the food and the people and the different places to go, then it really is a great experience and one that I always enjoy.
Rio, the path is clear for Argentina and England to meet in the semi-finals of the World Cup. When that happens, what do you reckon will happen?
If England get that far, they've done unbelievably well with the squad that we have. Very young players, inexperienced, but exciting. I think it's very exciting seeing this group of players going into the tournament, no fear, young, fresh guys. Argentina, I'll put them in one of the top three favourites for the tournament in my eyes. Them with Sergio and Messi. These guys are tough players, I think, experienced as well, along with Brazil and Spain, obviously, because they won the last three tournaments. But if they get to play each other, I'll be happy because two great teams with a lot of players that I'm excited about watching.
Pick a winner, Rio?
England.
You done it for me.
And you had one more question for Sergio.
Very quickly, Sergio, you know, congrats on your title win this year, but do you think Manchester United will be your main rivals again next year? Or are they too far behind?
Can you repeat your last part of the question?
Do you think Manchester United will be Manchester City's main rivals next year, or are they too far behind?
Siempre va a ser el City. El rival del United va a ser el City, así que esperemos que bueno que pueda ganar el mejor. Obviamente siempre gana uno, pierde uno.
Can we get this guy out of here now?
Bad man.
Security.
Very bad.
Now, hopefully the title race next season will be as exciting as this season, with Manchester United added to it as well. Right, let's get another question from the floor. Anyone else?
Rooney's brought two trainers along with him while he's on holiday to stay fit. So my question to both of you will be, you're in town for quite some time, you're pigging out, right? How are you planning on, you know, still making sure that you're still fit during this period of time while you're in Singapore?
Well, I'm not got enough to keep fit for, so I'm chilling. I'm enjoying it, man. Don't worry about me. But I think Rooney's maybe different to Sergio. Rooney's injured, so that's why he's got the two guys helping him. And I know Wayne, and he needs to help him. I'm joking, but he's I saw one of the videos. He looks kind of cool. He's like he's enjoying himself in the sun. But I'm sure Sergio can answer for himself.
Bueno, yo por ejemplo la otra semana ya arranco, el otro equipo, los demás jugadores arrancan la siguiente semana, yo por la lesión, pero bueno, espero poder prepararme bien porque obviamente un mundial no se juega todos los días.
This question for Rio, with regards to the Manchester United, the manager speculation and all, Louis van Gaal seems to be leading the race at the moment. What do you know about him and what sort of manager do you think United needs to get back in the title race?
From what I've seen and heard from various people, I think he seems very strong and direct and and he's got a good understanding and knowledge of what he wants to do. He's very certain about what he wants to do and doesn't really deviate from that. So, and to be at a club like Manchester United, I think you need to be like that. You need to have strong values and strong opinions and the will to follow them through. And he seems like he falls into that category. Every club he's been to, Bayern Munich, Barcelona, now with Holland, he seems to have gone in and done things his own way. So if he does come to Manchester United like everybody's anticipating, then I envisage him doing the same type of thing. And time will tell if it works or not.
Hi, this question is for Rio. As Juan Mata recently suggested, do you think that the absence of European football next season could be a blessing in disguise for Manchester United because of the lack of midweek exertions? Yeah,
100%. I think, no disrespect to Liverpool, but if Liverpool had been in the Champions League this season, I don't think they would have been where they were. You need a bigger squad. It's a lot tougher on this season, many more games, obviously. So next season, us being outside of Europe, I think, if people were going to back a team to kind of put a good challenge in, I think it'll be us just because of the volume of games. And I think that we're normally around March, April time, we're kind of normally patching players up to get out on the pitch to make sure that we kind of sustain a run in the league or in the cups. So without that, I think we'll have a fantastic chance next season.
There were four separate contests. The first one was the Singlish contest, which was won comfortably by Sergio Aguero. So 1-0 to Sergio Aguero there. The Singlish retweeting was won by Sergio. Yeah, Rio's not taking it. And he won't like this one either. Because in terms of the Tai Chi contest, this looked as though it had been won by Rio Ferdinand, but unfortunately, he didn't take a selfie. So he was disqualified from that. So now, Sergio Aguero has actually won the first two events out of four. We get to the Hawker Centre Challenge, which was won by Rio Ferdinand to make it 2-1. And then for the Flyer Retweet Challenge, talk about own goal, Sergio Aguero actually retweeted Rio's tweet. So he disqualified himself. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a draw, a 2-2. I wanted to leave it at a draw, but I've been told we have to find a winner, so we have to go and count back, which means the total amount of retweets taking away the disqualifications. And the winner is Mr. Rio Ferdinand, ladies and gentlemen. And that was for the challenges for day one.
At least you won something this year.
So congratulations, Rio. Well done. Right, some fantastic insights there.